wanted to make a quick and dirty unboxing and initial impressions of the solution offset smoker by the Mad Scientist BBQ, which is built by Smoker Builder. This is my second smoker, but the most professional and most money I've ever spent on a build. As you can see, it comes on this nice sturdy pallet. It is elevated on it with these Z brackets, so the wheels are not sitting on the pallet. It comes all wrapped up to prevent any kind of scratches with cellophane and this like foam type of material to prevent any kind of scratches in case you want to paint it or do some sort of coating later on. But at the end of the day, this thing is 600-700 pounds, and if it scratches or anything like that, it's an easy fix. But they do it anyways to protect it. It came on a box truck. The man was very kind, very professional, and he used a pallet jack to load it into my garage. Very happy with it. After they took my payment, I was told that it would take 4 weeks, but ended up being more like 5.5. But you know, I waited so long from the initial announcement of this that what was a, you know, another week or so. That wasn't a deal. Now, first opening this up, it was a little difficult. The door had settled during shipment, which I had not realized at this point. But I'm opening it up because all of the parts that you need to finish the assembly and to get this going are inside. In the white box, I ended up spending a little bit more money for the Mad Scientist's thermometer, which I feel that if you're going to, you know, buy this, what's a couple more bucks anymore anyway? It just adds to the aesthetics of it, which is nice. So if you want to support him and his channel, just go ahead and just buy it. But either way, if you already have a couple extra ones, they're all the standard sizes, so it would go into that bung that you see there on the left. Also in there was the door handle, which we will have to assemble. Now when I'm removing the grates, you probably should wear gloves. I did not. I wasn't really happy with the grates when I first took them out. They were very flimsy. They were also really small, and wasn't really too happy with them, but we'll talk about that later on. Now, the stack itself is pretty heavy, so be careful with it rolling around while you remove the baffle. You don't want to pinch your fingers or hit the edges of the door opening. There might be some burr still left over, so you may need to hit that with a file if you you know, want to smooth everything out, because it is still kind of raw in some places. Now, you may need two people to lift this out if you have a bad back or you can't lift anything heavy. There was some extra bolts just sitting at the bottom. They didn't go into anything. I ended up throwing them away. Maybe they went to the door handle. Not really sure. As you can see, the welds on these was really good. I was very impressed with the quality of the welds. All the way around on the outside, everything looked beautiful. Nice steady beads across everywhere. Now, before I took it off of the pallet, I did spray paint underneath it because it being elevated, it was easier to get underneath it before I took it off the pallet. So the whole thing is raw, so that's something to keep in mind, that before you take it off, if you need to get underneath it, now's the time to do it. And as you can see before, it has a beautiful little plate displaying the Mad Scientist logo and everything. The door was a little wonky. I ended up adjusting it, but this is to be expected. If, you know, maybe like during the shipment process, you know, it came a little loose, but it wasn't a big deal. Just a little bit of massaging, and it was a really nice tight fit. The wheels on this are great. They're high quality. They're not going to break. There's the closure for the stack. There's no lip on it, like it was talked about in another video. But I don't really... Mine sits inside right now, and it will be covered if it does sit outside. So, you know, water going down there is not going to be an issue. You can see the door has a nice brace on it to prevent warping and just give it some more rigidity. But this is where I was discovering that the door was just not sitting right. It wasn't really sitting flush. It was binding up on some part. And just more tack welds from the inside. This is just me looking at the door. It was sitting kind of like askewed on it. It wasn't really sitting square on it, and it was causing it to just be like raised up. So there was a huge, I would say, half inch gap almost to a quarter inch. But ended up calling Smoker Builder, and they walked me through the process of adjusting the door, which was fairly easy. I just undid the two bolts, held it up, and then just tightened everything down. But also, this beauty ring, I was wondering if it was also causing it to not sit flush. But basically, all you do is you take a crescent wrench, close it down on it, and then you can just tweak it down into the other direction. Now there was, you know, these little small fit and finishes that we do. It's to be expected. You know, it's a great price. It was easy. Customer service was great. But now this is the point where I need to get it off of the pallet. I used two jacks and some stands to get it off. You got to be really careful because it is very heavy. I have a bad back, so this is how I did it. I just slowly did it and walked it through. Taking it off on the firebox side. That is the heaviest side, so when it does come down over it, just be careful it doesn't flip up and just get away from you. And there it is, sitting finally on the ground. Now, like I said, there's some burrs and stuff that you might need to be careful about. I hit mine with a file. And I was wondering and just looking at it to see why it was kind of binding up at this time. And here's the beauty ring, and you can see it's all tacked around. And I'm wondering if maybe when the technician was tacking it on, they went just a little too quick and it just kind of warped the metal. But at the end of the day, I was able to massage it back into place. And this is me walking through trying to figure out how to put the door handle on. It was very springy, so like the bolt is shorter than the spring, so I had to like squish it in and just trying to feel and trying to thread it in. It was a little tricky, so just be aware of that. And there was no instructions of like how any of the bolts or washers are supposed to go in on this, so it's just kind of just a figure it out. So I put it on there, it was a little weird. Maybe the other washers that were in there was supposed to go to this, but the bag that the spring and the bolt were in were all sealed, so I didn't think it went to it, but it was a little weird and wavy, so I took it off and I just put the washer on the handle side of the door. I felt like it just kind of aligned a little bit better. So if you're just trying to be a little OCD like myself, just put the washer on the left side, closest to the firebox. And it was just a little tricky because, you know, the bolt is shorter than the spring. You know, thinking about it, hindsight, maybe having it into that latch to hold it instead of my knee probably would have been the better idea, but it is what it is. Took 2 seconds, as you can see, first attempt, and we got it on. Just hand tighten it down. It will keep going as far as you keep twisting it because it is an all thread bolt. And here I am playing with the door, trying to make sure it's closing, but it was kind of binding up a little funny. Ended up just massaging it into place. Now on the stack, you will have these bolts that you will have to remove before you install the stack, because these are the bolts you're going to use. On the right hand side, you can see the little flap that have the temperature probe goes through. I had to loosen mine up because mine was really tight on there, but a wrench will loosen it up, that way it will just hang flat. But I think they do that so it doesn't get lost during shipment. Having a tray makes this process go a little bit easier. I just got a magnetic tray to put everything on. You can just throw it in a box or something else. There's these two little cutouts on it. I don't know what it's from. I think it's from the manufacturing process. So like maybe they put a jig on there so they can make sure all of their bolt holes line up, which they did. So that's what I think those little notches are, but they have nothing to do with mounting the stack. I think it's just for the alignment of all the holes. So you just need to reach around and just feed them through the holes, and then boom, there they all through, and I'm just going to do a quick tight down. You don't need to use an impact gun like I have. You can just do them with some wrenches, but you know, I have these tools, so this is what I used. Now we're going to install the thermometer. Here it is. Nice, beautiful, brand new. Enjoy it while it lasts. Looking this good. It has a locking nut on it. Or a locking ring, whatever you want to call these things. You see them on electrical boxes and such when you're doing electrical work. And when you're doing electrical work, they usually go on the inside of the box to cinch everything in. But in this case, we're using the locking nut on the outside, which I soon found out. Because like I said, maybe there was something in the instructions, but I don't read instructions. I think in the instructions there was a like how to calibrate it if you need to, but I'm pretty sure they come preset. So then they put the locking ring, put it back to where it came in the box. And the locking ring, what that's going to do is keep it in an upright position, because if you just keep going, it's not going to be, you know, up and down. So get it to how you want it, put the locking ring on it like this, and then just get like a flathead screwdriver and just give it a little how's your father to lock it into place. And then Bob's your uncle. All right, now we are going to put the baffle in there. I'm going to keep playing with this. I think I'm going to, there's these little feet on there. I'm gonna play with this a little more later on, because when I first get it, it's just kind of sitting in there and it's not very sturdy. So I ended up just like shoving it in there with the bar that holds on the grades. So I think I'm gonna come reattack this later on and just bend these bars out. But it wasn't like totally flush, it was kind of weird. So you might need to get some, a wrench and just give it a little bit of tweaking to how you want it. I don't know. I wasn't really sure how it went in. It was just kind of wobbly in there. And here's the grates. And so these grates are not the ones that are supposed to come with it, apparently. They called me up, I think the next day after it was built, telling me that they delivered the smoker with the wrong plates. So there's supposed to be a ring around it. You can see they're too small. There's a gap. It's weird. I didn't know what was going on with this. I just knew that it didn't look right. It was flimsy. They were warped. I didn't feel good about putting meat on here. I was thinking, what am I going to do? But as you can see, they shit me out. There's a nice ring around it. Now they're straight. They're flat. They're sturdy. I'm not going to cut myself on any of the burrs. So it was nice that they reached out, and I didn't have to go to them. They came to me. They identified the issue. I could not be more happy with Smoker Builder. Customer service is great. While we were talking, they also were addressing my door concerns, telling me how to fix it with the wrench and everything. I got it into place. And they were saying how, you know, if I wanted to have 100% sealed box, which is, it's not necessary, but I wanted to make sure that mine didn't have any big gaps. But basically what you do is you take some painter's tape or masking tape, you put it around, you take some Dawn dish soap, you put it on the tape, and then you take some high temperature silicone. Now, I had some left over from a previous project from working on cars, so I gave it a shot, and you put a nice bead around the whole door frame, and then you just shut it. And you give it a day for it to set in place. Now, mine wasn't 100%. I might re-attack this later on, because my OCD of being 100% sealed. But there's so much smoke coming out of this, so much heat and air movement, that a little bit of smoke coming out of the door is not gonna really affect the cook or temperatures or anything. But maybe you don't want to stand there and have smoke in your face, whatever. But after you shut it, you squish it down, and this is kind of what it looks like. Now, at certain stores, they have those huge tubes of caulk that for, like, you know, bathtub size. And that's really what you want to get, because I used two tubes of the small stuff from Automotive, and it didn't really work out. I ran out, so I'm probably going to reattack it. And this is just it the next day after it set into place. Now, I'm going to go ahead and just hit this with some barbecue paint on the bottom side, because I just want to protect it from the elements as much as possible. I ended up wiping it down with just a wet towel, and I'm just going to mask this up really quick and just hit it up with some barbecue paint. I only used one can for the bottom and for all the legs. It was a little bit of a stretch. If you want a thick coating, you're going to need two cans of spray paint. And just moving this thing around on these wheels is so easy and effortless. And yeah, it's a smooth surface on the garage, but my garage has probably a half inch to 1 inch lip before it comes in and out of the garage. And these wheels, because of the size of them, goes over that lip so easy. Now, there's no handle or anything for when you're moving it around, but I just grab it by the smokestack and just wheel it around. Not an issue. Alright, now after I wiped it down, I sprayed it with some PAM, and then I'm going to start a fire. I got it up to 550 degrees. I came from an Oklahoma Joe, so I had all these small sticks left over, and I soon realized that I need a lot more wood. compared to my Oklahoma Joe. This thing probably takes twice the amount of wood that the Oklahoma Joe ever took. Because usually they have these boxes at Walmart or with hickory that you get for like 20 bucks. On my Oklahoma Joe, I could go through maybe half a box, where this, through the same cook, over 8 hours, took the whole box. Now, I was about 4 hours into it, and I didn't really was getting the results of it darkening up like I wanted to, so I wiped it off. I used some tallow that seemed to help out a little bit more. I also hit it with a torch with map gas, but at the end of the day, after 8 hours at 550 degrees, it just wasn't really setting up on the smoke box side of it. The firebox, nice dark coating on it, but just be prepared to maybe get it with like one of those blow torches that you would for like grass or something. That's what I'm probably going to do. And here it is after hitting it with the oil and starting it up. I used way too much. I ended up wiping it down. But after this for 8 hours and then two smokes that lasted 8 hours, this is the results. As you can see, it darkens up really nice on the firebox side. And you know, as you go with it, it's gonna darken up, it's gonna bronze up. But I think on my next one, I'm just gonna hit it with the torch, but something that provides more BTUs. But overall, really happy with the quality. Yeah, there was some tweaking that you need to do, but the price that you get, this thing cannot be beat. The customer service with Smoker Builder cannot be beat. These guys are amazing. I would definitely do a business with these guys again. Couldn't be more happier. So, thank you for watching this. Hopefully it gave you some information. I need to reseason the grates, because you can see that was after I put in 2 racks of ribs. And I'm going to adjust the baffle as well. Got to play around with that. Lots to learn on this new smoker, guys. I hope you like it. I know I am. Take it easy. Have a good day.